Come on, give the Lord a big old hand clap of praise, for he is worthy to be praised. I remember you sang this old crowd family song. It says something like this: I woke up this morning and there wasn't no hearse at my front door. Amen. So I got something to praise God for. Amen. If you got a special need in the house tonight, you wouldn't just signify by the waving of your hand, wave towards the heavens. If you're physically able, would you please stand with me? If you're not physically able, just remain seated and reverence God. Wave that hand one more time towards the heavens. Father God, you see every hand, you know, every situation, every circumstance. Father God, we enter into your presence through the shed blood of Jesus Christ, our Lord and our Savior. Father God, we thank you for the opportunity to assemble together to exalt your name in this place tonight. God, we ask you to just bless each and every one, each family that's represented, every hand that was raised. God, you know every situation, every circumstance. God, we surrender that circumstance or situation under your care tonight. God, as we lay it down at the feet, at the cross, and God, we believe that you're well and able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above, beyond all that we can ask or even think this day. God, I ask you to lay your hand upon the youth tonight. God, as they begin to minister tonight, God, we ask you to lay your hand upon the musicians and the singers. God, upon the man of God tonight, you lay your hand upon him, and we'll give you all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. For it's in the name of Jesus we pray. The church said, amen. Amen. Somebody praising like you fell head over heels in love with Jesus. Freedom Drama Team, are you ready? Well, you're going to be doing Dare You to Move first. So if you want to get ready for Dare You to Move tonight, we're going to let our youngins do a couple. We might want to get off the front two pews, and we won't take no blows to the head. Y'all kind of be easy. We'll savor really dramatic falls and spills and everything for next Sunday night. Amen? We would like to welcome everyone to Lighthouse of Praise and Hope Church. If this is your first visit, I hope it's not your last. I hope you have a good time. I hope someone extends a hand of love to you, makes you feel welcome. Amen. Anytime during the dramas or anytime during the praise and worship or anytime during preaching, if you feel like you need to come and pray, I'll promise you these children won't mind stepping aside. These young adults won't mind stepping to the side and going and praying with you. Amen. And laying down burdens and getting what we need from God. Amen. Are y'all ready, young ones? Thumbs up? Amen. Let the Freedom Drama Team know how much we love them and appreciate them tonight. Yeah. Come on, give the Lord a big old hand clap of praise. How many know that the enemy will always try to show you a picture, but he only wants you to see the part that he wants you to see? That's sort of what that, go ahead and get ready for a glorious day, y'all. That's sort of what that skit is trying to tell us is he always tempts us with the things. You'll see the peer pressure, and you'll see the temptations, and you'll see the unforgiveness, and you'll see the addictions, and you'll see the all those things that takes place, and how the enemy will always try to tell us that, oh, it's not going to be that way this time. It's okay. But you know what? The enemy only has one place, and that's destruction. He'll always say the grass is greener on the other side. What he fails to tell you is under that green grass is nothing but a sewage septic tank. Amen. But I'm thankful today that God is more than able. Amen. Let Freedom Drama Team know how much we love them and appreciate them one more time tonight.
Rising, he just freely forever.
tonight, for he is so worthy to be praised. Amen. Band three, if you would. If I can get some help with the pulpit. Somebody help get it in its position tonight. Band three, if you would, come on the instruments. We can play without my mom. As difficult as it's going to be. Band three. Amen. I'm not for sure which way we're going or what's taking place this morning, because I believe all three of the preachers preached that was present, to the best of my knowledge. We may do it the same way again tonight. I don't know. I just don't have no program, no format, don't even have nothing in the back of my mind. But I do know this, and we will let God be God. Amen. I challenge you, will you let God be God in your life? Will you let him be God in your life? That's where the question is. Amen. Come on, give me some praise, for he's worthy. First of all, I'd like to say I do love the Lord tonight. Like Tim said this morning, I just want to say I love him because he loved me first. And I wanted to thank him for everything he's done in my life and for my family's life and in my family. I got to thinking about what was preached last weekend, Acts 16. I know it is hard to get out of Acts. But when Paul was in the prison, the ruckus came and the quake came and opened the doors. The chains and all was broke off of them and broke off everybody, every prisoner there, not just them, everybody. And the doors were opened. You know, the centurions and the soldiers and the guards, they started to get scared, Sean, because anybody that let them out or something like that, they would die because of that. Anybody let that out? And they started getting scared. And Paul looked at him, grabbed a hold of them, and he said, "Be ye not afraid. We're still here. We're still here. We ain't going nowhere. God ain't going to put nobody in no position to get nobody hurt." And on down the line, the centurion looked at Paul, and he said, "What must I do to be saved?" And he said, "Believe on Jesus Christ." And there's something else I like what he said. He said, "If you believe this, you and your house shall be saved." And I remember when the Lord told me that not a while back ago. When you get your life right, I'm going to see to it the others get their life right. So if you're a mama and daddy in here today, and if you ain't got God in your life, and Jesus living in your heart, hey, back up and get your life right and watch God go to work. Because you know what? That's a promise. There's a bunch of promises in the Bible. But that was a promise Paul made. He told that centurion. He said, "You and your house. If your house ain't running right, get your life right with God and watch him go to work." Because that's one of the promises he's made to us. Y'all stand up and give him praise, because he deserves it. Hey, nobody deserves it except beside you or outside the door or in your house right now. Nobody deserves the praise that he deserves, because he is the one. He is God. He's the one that made us. Book of Psalms says he's the one that made us and not ourselves. We are the sheep in his pasture. And I'm going to tell you something. That's a great big old pasture right there. I'll guarantee, if you know anything about a pasture, when the livestock go to eating the grass and everything, they usually got it put out in sections. And when the livestock run out of that grass, they go to moving them. They move them somewhere else. So if you get into a place there ain't no grass this evening, let's get moved tonight. Let's go somewhere else where the grass is greener on the other side with Jesus Christ. Y'all stand up and love him. I do.
Eli, weather be, remedy and our grace.
Amen. That's where I'm going. Amen. Let's do a little. Can we do a little praise, Melanie? I think we got the lyrics up there, and I hope I sing it the right way. If I say something ain't up there, just ignore what I said and sing what that's up there. Some of y'all get that on the way home.
C chord. Sorrow inside. Praise the Lord.
Somebody else want to testify tonight before we do another song? Anybody in the house? Come on, sister. Amen. Give God some praise. Come on, young man. Amen. Give God praise. Mr. Alex. Amen. Give God praise. Mr. Braylon. Amen. Give God praise. Mr. Aaron. Amen. Give God some praise. Mr. Leland. Amen. Give God praise. Come on, young man. Amen. Give God praise. Come on, sweetheart. Amen. Give God praise. Come on, sweetie. Amen. Give God praise. Come on, sweetie. Amen. Give God praise. The Bible said, out of the mouth of babes will you have perfected praise. Amen. So I know that the little kids expect us to lead them in the right direction and teach them and train them, but you know, you can learn a lot from a little kid too. It's called childlike faith. It's having faith in the things that you cannot see. Because why would you hope in something you can see? Our hope is in the things that we can't see with the natural eye, that we learned this morning, that we can take a visit into our understanding and a vision of our own. Anybody remember what was going on this morning? Amen. Somebody give him praise like he's worthy of. Somebody else want to testify? We're going to get ready to do one more song. Amen. Give God praise. Jesus on the main line. We're back in the court of C, I believe. I've never seen lots of pressure singing when you put the words up, but I have to really pay attention. I can't just sing it how I feel it. I got to actually sing it the way it's wrote. Huh? Amen. I'm Pentecostal to the bone. I just say whatever I feel. Amen. So if y'all don't feel it, y'all need to pray harder. Amen. Here we go. Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line. Tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line.
Call him up, tell him what you want. Jesus.
want, deliver us. Tell him what you want. Jesus on the main line now. We'll call him up, call him up. Tell him what you want. Call him up, tell him what you want. Time.
One thing when I know for sure, I know what I'm a shout about. Those they can try to stop me, but thunder falls my way. Well, I stand up and for my heart, and this is the words I say. Well, I'm gonna put on my Jesus just the same.
How many knows that if anybody should be celebrating, it should be the church? Let me hear you say amen to that. Now, I know a lot of folks is going to disagree with what I'm about to say. And I've grown to learn the people that disagree just ain't become the church. I thought it'd get quiet. Amen. If anybody should be celebrating, it should be the church. It shouldn't be any college football team, or it shouldn't be any high school team, or it shouldn't be any, what's that called, stock market, or anything like that. If anybody's going to win, it's going to be the church. I've read the scripture, said, upon this rock, I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail over it. If you don't understand what all the excitement's all about, maybe you need to become part of the church and you'll understand what the rejoicing's all about. It's hard to rejoice when you're bound down in sin. It's hard to shout when you got your shout took away from you. I know what I'm preaching about now. Hey, hey. Has anybody here ever had your shout taken away from you since you've been saved? Come on, you know what I'm talking about. Maybe you went somewhere you shouldn't have went, done something you shouldn't have done, said something you shouldn't have said, or didn't say something you should have said, and all of a sudden your shout gets taken. Can I tell you something? When they marched around the walls of the city one time every day for 6 days straight, but on the seventh day, Joshua told them, said, I want you to be quiet. I don't want you to say a word. I don't want you to make a sound. I want you to march around the walls one time a day for 6 days, but on the seventh day, I want you to march around it seven times. But some, I want you to do something different on the seventh time than you've done all the other 12 times before. I noticed, Brother Sean Baker, there's 12 trips around the wall, one for every disciple. They went 6 days one time, and then the seventh day they went six times, and then on the seventh one. That seventh time was for you and me. He said, on the seventh time when the priest blows the trumpet, I want you to shout with all that's within you. And all the mockers and all the ones that was making fun of it, say, you can believe however you want to. I got to see this thing. I seen it. I was sitting in church and I seen it. People up on the walls laughing at them every day as they walked around the walls of the city laughing. I said, hey, told you your God couldn't do it. On the fifth day, the sixth day, told you your God couldn't do it. Now what you going to do? On the seventh day, the sixth trip, still making fun and joke, but on the seventh time. When the shout came out, the walls came down, and whoever was on the walls fell with the walls. I want to tell you, whoever's been laughing at you and mocking you and talking about you, it's okay, honey. It's the seventh day and the seventh time. Just shout and watch the walls fall down. I want to tell you, when God does something, he does it right. Didn't have to step over nothing, around anything. The Bible said the walls fell flat. They just stepped. Look over at somebody and tell them, how dare you to step into the water. The miracle is in the water. Amen. The angel come down a certain time in a season in the book of John chapter 5 and stirred the water. And whoever jumped in it first got the miracle, got the healing, got the cleansing, got the deliverance. Can I tell you tonight, the healing's in the water. Do you want to get in? Look over at somebody and say, do you want to get in? I want to tell you something, church. We ain't got to wait till we get there to celebrate. We celebrate tonight just knowing that I'm going. Somebody give God some praise.
I'll be singing.
Philippian jailer. Come on, young man. Amen. Give him praise. Somebody else got something burning. Better give it. Amen. Give God some praise during the prayer request. Somebody else tonight.
Truly love the Lord tonight. I'm thankful for his word. Paul said we weren't redeemed by corruptible things like silver and gold, but by the precious blood of the Lamb, as of a lamb without spot, without blemish. I read Isaiah 53 and it reads me back. And the Word of God does that a lot. I can read it, it'll wind up reading me. But the Bible said that he was led like a lamb to the slaughter. And there was no guile in his mouth. Isaiah 53 said that we esteemed him stricken and smitten of God. It looked like he's the one who messed up. Looked like he was the one being punished. But he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquities. And the chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes, we are healed. And God, I'm not having to wait on it anymore, Philip Plant. It's a done deal. Jesus paid the price for it. And I can see that in my mind. I can see that tonight. It pleased the Father to crush you because of us. That was the great love that God had. For God so loved the whole world. The whole world and me. I'm like Peter. You tell them all and Sean. Because I've bloated a lot in my life. I'm thankful tonight that the blood of Jesus Christ cleanses me from all my sin. And it ought to be, and we shouldn't have to make somebody stand up and shout. We ought not make somebody have to stand up and give a testimony. I shouldn't have to try to manipulate the praise out of somebody. If they met the same Jesus I met, Philip Plant, if they had their life changed the way my life's been changed, I don't have to get my praise worked up. I get out of bed in the morning thanking God, amen, that I'm his child. And I'm thankful that there's a hedge around me. And I'm thankful there's a hedge around my family. I'm thankful that I am above and not beneath. I'm the head and not the tail. I keep on speaking it. It don't matter what it looks like, Philip Fant. I know that God cannot lie. It's not that he won't lie or he don't want to, but he cannot because he's true. I'm thankful tonight. That's one of the ways you get into the gate is with a thankful heart. Do you have something to be thankful for tonight? I'm thankful that the scripture said he was delivered up for our offenses, but he was raised for our justification. God proved it was a done deal when he raised him from the dead. If Christ be not raised from the dead, we're still in our sin, amen. But I'm glad to know tonight they moved into my heart. I opened the door and said, Lord, come in. Listen, he didn't rent a room from you. He bought the whole house. He don't want just in the living room. He wants in the closet. He wants in the bedroom. He wants in the computer room. He wants the whole house, amen. I'm thankful tonight. The Word of God said Abraham believed God. And it was imputed to him for righteousness. God's not asking you to do a marathon. Build cottages in third world countries. Or orphanages. He's asking you to believe him and he'll do those things through you. Because the minute we start thinking that we're going to deserve it because of what I did, then we push the blessing away. But the minute we say, God, I believe you. Abraham believed God, and he was counted a friend of God. When I pray, I see it. When I'm thankful, I see it. And I see you blessed. I see your house free. I see chains broke off your family. Amen, because God's word's true. Let God be true and every man a liar. Amen. That's what the Word said. I'm going to believe what God said. I mean, believe what God said. Well, let me tell you one of the promises that I stand on every day in my life. He said, we've already been given all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of him. I've already got everything I need for this life, Philip Plant. God promised me I did. Now I got to walk it out. Let me give you another promise. Let me give you another problem. We've already been seated together with Jesus Christ in heavenly places. Not gonna be, already have been. That's why Paul said, set your affections on things above. Not on things beneath, but set them on things above where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. My Lord, my Savior, my Redeemer, my Judge Advocate, makes intercession for me every day according to the will of God. That ought to excite somebody. Already been, well, I don't see it. You're not going to have it first. You got to see it. You got to have faith. Then it manifests. Then you see it. You're not going to get anything from God without faith. Well, when I see it, I'll start believing it. I dare you to just worship. Just break out into worship in the middle of the day. Jesus, I worship you and I love you. It don't matter where you're at. I dare you to just break out in worship somewhere in your life and watch the power of God fall. It don't have to be in the church. That's where we mess up. Because we'll come to church for a couple hours, then we'll go get back in the world. We'll go get back on HBO, and we'll get back on the internet, and we'll fill our garden with trash and choke out the word that you got this morning. There's some things happened last Sunday night in this church that the devil's probably been talking to some of you young and telling you that wasn't right, that wasn't real. Don't lie to me. I know how it works. That wasn't real. I know some of you have been feeling that. God told me. I'm going to tell you it was real. It was real. What's not real is what the lie was told to you. That's what's not real. Amen? Because the devil's a liar and the father of it. Every time he opens his mouth, it's a lie. If he speaks to you, it's a lie. Jesus said he can't tell the truth. Truth ain't in him. He was a liar from the beginning. He said, I saw him fall like lightning from the sky. That's my Lord. And I believe the scripture said, Pastor, I believe you preached it before, that the Lord will bruise Satan under your feet shortly. How many know that time? That shortly is almost here, amen? That shortly is almost here because the Son of God is fixing to come in the clouds with power and great glory and say, come up here, church. Come up here, bride. He's going to leave the rest of it here, amen? I'm going home with Jesus. Can you get excited for just a minute? Here's about 5 more minutes. Can you go home, get excited about Pretty Little Liars or HBO, whatever you got recorded? But if you just get excited for about 5 minutes with God, amen, watch him do a miracle in your life. Watch him start stomping the enemy out from around you, amen. Because if the worldly things excite you, then you're going to miss God. My affections are not on him anymore, Philip. I've grown in my relationship with him. Nothing excites me but him anymore. Because when the river meets the road, when the smoke clears, if you ain't got Jesus, you ain't got nothing. But I'm glad tonight that he loved me enough to go on. He humbled himself and became obedient. He was God. God, Philip, humbled himself and became a servant and died on the cross, shed his blood for me and for you. He's worthy of worship tonight. He's worthy of it tonight. Won't you give him a hand clap tonight? Give him praise like he's worthy. Lord, I hope you blow the satellite out of the sky when they can't even watch TV the rest of the week. Y'all keep on, I'll ask you to turn all the power off. We have a stinking candlelight vigil. But I know he's still God in the dark, amen? I know he's still God in the dark. He's God in the valley. He's God in the dark. He's God on the mountain. He'll never lose his power, glory to God.
Stand up if you love Jesus. Stand up. Stand up, tell him all about it. Stand up and testify. Have you ever had a bad day? Ever had a sad day? Nothing Jesus, stand up, identify. Stand up, tell him all about it. Stand up and testify. Right.
Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Somebody else want to testify? Before we go in a direction.
I want to say I love the Lord. Thank him for saving my soul. You know, I've had those bad days. I've had those days where I wouldn't go out and witness to nobody. But I thank God one day, you know, there's coming a day. There's gonna be a day that God splits the eastern skies. We're going home. And I'm waiting on that day. I'm going to start standing up for Jesus. I'm going to start standing up for what I believe in.
Bless you, Lord.
I want to start standing up for my family, for my church family,
bless you,
for
Lord.
This church.
Bless you, Lord.
You know, we're part of the start. That's what it's all about. Standing up for the one that went to the cross
Amen.
For us.
Amen.
I just
want to
say I love the Lord and thank you.
Amen. Give God some praise. I want to ask. I know there was some lives that got changed here this morning. I know I was at a couple of stations this morning that I believe that their lives was changed. And I'm not big at putting people on the spot. Trust me. That's not what God called me into. That's not the ministry that I practice, preach, nor teach. But we would love to come around and just fellowship with you in our dismissing tonight. So if you was here this morning or tonight, and you made a commitment to God and you know that God's changed your life, if you would you please come down tonight and stand and we can come around and love and fellowship with you and just hug on you just for a little while. Bring somebody with you. Don't come by yourself. Bring somebody with you. If you can't get nobody else to go, I'll go. Bring somebody with you. Go stand. Come on. I know there's at least two more in here that their lives was changed. Do you want to come tonight? Somebody come with you, just loving fellowship with you. It's through confession. I mean, you know, it's up to you. If you want to be really, truly rewarded, you have to confess what's happened and what's taking place in your life. That's part of the process, is confession. Now, listen to me. Now, when I say confession, don't go get freaking out on me and think we've got to go into this little room and confess to man, because that's not the confession I'm talking about. I'm talking about telling somebody what great, mighty things God just done for you. You didn't have to go in no little closet and speak to the little hole and ask the Father to say four Hail Marys for you. And I'm talking about that you went behind the veil where it was ripped in the glory of God. And you went into his presence through the shed blood of Jesus Christ. And God is definitely changing your life. So church, if y'all would, if you want to just everybody just come around and love and fellowship with these ones. Let them know we love them, appreciate them. We'll be there for them to the best of our ability in every way that we can. Through prayer, through fasting, through words of encouragement. I'm not sure where we're at. I think E, B, and A, I think we played it one time in our life.
Well, I'm an old man walking down the street. His clothes was worn and tattered, and sandals on his feet. And I stopped and to help him and lend him a hand. He said, I love you so much. You must understand that silver and gold. But things of this world, they won't last too long. And time is a way of turning us old. And time can be brought back with silver and gold. To me, let's rest for a while, cause I have some good news to share with you, my child. You can't change this old world. But people need to know that a dear Savior died here a long, long time ago. He said, "Silver and gold, my fire you pay for, but things of this world, they won't last too long, and time has a way of turning us old, and time can be promised with silver and gold."
Anybody else want to testify tonight before we change the service?